Norman, and these are the festive tiles. There's Holly Willoughby's. I'd love to empty my sack on those baubles. Yeah, boy! And there's Falcon. She's been a naughty boy this year. Look, there's Shigo Sheffield DiCampo. He's always asking people if they want stuffing. We're all here in this heavenly wonderland, but don't worry, we're not dead. It's just a cheap way of sprucing up the tiles for Christmas. We're still here to make the best show on telly. What is that show on telly? It's Celebrity Juice on telly.
Ho, ho, ho! It's going to be an absolute cracker, you fuckers.
Special Celebrity Juice Christmas special. I'm a massive fan of Panto, so as you can see, I am dressed as Captain Hook. I'm surprised I haven't put this as a dildo. I thought this would have been a dildo. It's Celebrity Juice. Anyway, let's meet our team captains. First up, it's Flint Cotton! Who would have thought you would look more sexy as a boy? You do look good as Robin Hood.
Thank you.
Was a rhyme!
You do look good as Robin Hood. Oh, no! Oh, no, he doesn't! Oh, yes, he does. Oh, no, he doesn't!
My balls just got really happy. Fern, who's on your team?
Oh, she's a right Christmas cracker. It's Susanna Ree! And on my right, he or she's behind you, it's Danny Dyer! Isn't she beautiful?
What's weird, how drunk I am right now. You look fit as well, Danny.
You fat me, weren't you?
I was. OK, let's meet our other team captain. It's Holly Willoughby!
Holy shit, balls. The fairy godfucker.
No. You can't think of the godmother like that.
Why?
Well, because it's not right.
Is she right nice, godmother?
She's pure as the driven snow.
Would she stick a wand up my ass as part of love making? Because I normally don't go in the arsehole. It's just for pooing out of. But my mate told me if a girl sticks a finger up your ass, you come straight away. Have you ever just put your finger in and the man has has produced his juice straight away?
No.
Have you had that done to you?
What, I had a thing about me off?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've had a thing about me off.
And what was it like?
It was my own finger, like. What?
Holly, who's on your team?
On my left, I hope he's been a good boy this year. It's Piers Morgan. This very mysterious magical lamp.
Holly, give it a rub.
Okay.
It's Tom Cruise!
Tom.
Oh no, it's a cardboard cutout. What a shame.
Okay.
I did phone him though, but he said he wouldn't do it. Give it another rub. It again. Up again.
I think if I rub it again, something might happen.
Rub it again.
I'm all new.
Oh, it's Jeannie DiCampo! Stand up, what's that look here?
This kind of suits you, Gino.
It's all natural.
You look like sort of the entertainment you get in a really bad hotel.
I'll give you a piece of advice, Gino. Stay off the bread, man. Ooh!
What is that?
Don't say that.
Stay off the bread.
I don't like men with six-pack. I never like that. I think you need one pack. That's the most important one. Fucking get on with your life.
She's the fittest woman on morning telly. It's Susanna Ree! Yeah. She's you know, for me, when you started doing Good Morning Telly,
yeah,
it was like I was watching American telly, because a lot of people on those shows in America are fit. Mm. And then suddenly we've got you, and I was like, oh, wow, it's good, man.
Do you still feel like that with me dressed as Snow White?
Oh, even more so! Look at those milk trucks, boy! Check them milk trucks! Holly's envious! Look at those!
It's true! Luckily, they're covered with tinsel.
They will be covered in tinsel. Susanna, I read in a magazine recently...
Oh, it must be true, then.
..that you want to get Piers sacked.
Oh, yes! I read that in that magazine as well.
Bella, yeah. I want him sacked.
Really naughty about that. That was actually a viewer who said that. They just put it in quotes over my face.
Can't stand it when magazines and papers misquote people like that.
I know. The irony was, you believed it.
Well, when you've been sacked as much as I have, you don't like reading it.
I've heard you two, though, together a bit naughty, aren't you?
What do you do?
I've got a friend called Shaniqua, who works at Good Morning Britain.
Oh, she's awesome.
And she said that the Good Morning Britain Christmas party was insane, like a movie for teenagers.
I don't remember.
They found these pictures on the photocopy machine.
Yeah. First one.
This is definitely Kate Garraway.
Awesome.
Yeah. We all know who this is because apparently he's got the biggest cock in daytime TV. This is true.
Is that
cheers
is
for
that
this, Shaniqua.
Huh? Is that the rumour?
You never heard Ben Shepherd's got a big dong?
No. That looks like a hot dog, that picture.
Bigger than John Barrowman's. You've seen his, haven't you?
No.
You put a fucking hat on him, it looks like a sailor. And this one, I've seen this sort of thing like in porn, when you know when they pull it open. When they pull arse open. You've seen it, Gina. When they let the hands go, it stays open. Yeah. There. Oh, no, it's upside down. Oh, no, it's Piers! It's Piers! It's the bad boy morning, Telly. It's Piers Morgan!
Why do they boo you?
Horrible audience. Absolutely.
It's Panto, isn't it?
Repulsive people. Christmas, yeah.
Piers, we've been trying to get you on Juice
for
many years. Yeah. Are you happy to be here?
Not really. No.
Are you happy to be anywhere?
Not really. When you walk in and a whole lot of people boo you, it's just not very nice. It's not very Christmassy. I'm very happy to be here. I love this show. You just couldn't afford me before tonight, so... We got the check-up, and here I am.
You're against each other tonight.
Yeah, as usual, actually.
Are you very competitive?
Yes.
Yeah? What was it like working with him?
I was hoping, Holly, as you made Gino appear, you could make Piers disappear.
Do you prefer working with Ben Shepherd?
Oh, Piers is...
Just be very careful what you do.
We've got a picture of you sat on the sofa on Good Morning Britain. Here you are with Ben, and there you are, Piers.
Pretty much sums it up then, doesn't it?
Happy face.
So, Piers, you started your career as the editor of the News of the World and the Daily Mirror. Mm-hmm. You must have met enough famous people, yeah?
I've met a few.
Yeah, I think we've got some pictures of you meeting some famous people. There you are with Stallone, Arnie and Bruce Willis.
Well, they look really fucking thrilled to see me, don't they?
We've got another picture of you here with one of your friends.
Oh, yeah.
Dalai Lama.
Yeah.
What's he like in real life when he comes out of character?
Yeah. The thing about Dalai Lama, he's never had sex, obviously. He's never had a drink, never had a cigarette.
But did he still call you a c***? Let's have another picture of you. Look there, meeting the Queen.
Yeah.
There's Simon Cowell in the background.
Yeah.
What was the Queen like?
She wasn't overly chatty with me.
Did she think you were a c*** as well?
Is this the theme of the evening?
Piers, apparently, I don't know if this is true, Jeremy Clarkson, you were the first person he ever punched.
Correct.
Yes?
And he wasn't sacked for that. In fact, he became a national hero. How does that work? You punch me and everyone loves you, you punch some BBC producer and you get sacked. I didn't get that.
Why did he punch you?
I don't really want to re-legislate what happened, but there was a misunderstanding involving various...
Did he say you were a c***?
He did say that. In between the second and third punch, yes.
Well, here at Celebrity Juice, we think it's a big achievement to be the first person ever to be punched by Jeremy Clarkson. So, Piers, we'd like to award you with this special award. Hail!
Thank you very much. Awards, so getting this phallic splendid trophy is magnificent. Thank you.
Where are you going to put it?
I'm going to use it.
Just give it a smell.
This
That's Holly's. Don't fucking mug me off, it's Dolly Dyer.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Renata, because recently you got married. Congratulations! There you are. Look at that.
She's here tonight and missing somewhere. She ain't up, bud.
There she is up there. Congratulations! What was Danny Dyer like doing his vows? Did you go, yeah, I'll fucking marry her, she's a salt? did you swear?
I went, see you, you fucking raving little thing. I fucking love you. I love ya, because I fucking live with ya.
You're related to royalty, apparently.
Yeah. No,
Here's the headline, Sunday Express. Royal EastEnders star Danny Dyer is related to the monarch from the 1600s.
No, my 22 times great-grandfather is Edward III.
They'd be so proud of you.
Does that technically mean you're an heir to the throne?
Well, yeah, if I iron out about 150 people, yeah, I'll be fucking king. If Trump can run America, I can be fucking king, sure.
You do the royal wave?
But I've just fucking done it, haven't it?
It's a lot going, isn't it?
It's good, it's good.
You go like this, start going like that.
Just in case we can sell this idea to ITV2 to do the alternative Queen's speech, yeah. How about doing the King's speech in a posh voice down camera 5?
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a wonderful year. It's been a year of ups, it's been a year of downs. It's been a year of fucks, it's been a year of f***s. But I wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas and a fucking naughty New Year.
Yeah! Okay, it's time to ramp up the festivities now as we play a real Christmassy game. It's none other than Don't Show Keith Your Christmas Tea! Play along at home. The category is obvious, it's Christmas time, so the category is Christmas things. Gingo.
Bim bam bam.
Why do you always say Peppa Pig?
Bing bam bam.
A bingo bell.
Bing bam bam. Bing bam bam. Bing bam bam. Bing bam bam. Bam
bam bam. Ollie.
Turkey.
Oh?
Turkey.
Turkey? What, the interviewer?
No,
Parky. Oh, okay, Parky. I want to have a Parky then. Piers.
Christmas cracker.
Oh?
Christmas cracker.
Get it?
Christmas cracker.
Tell me
what. Bang beer. Bang
Bambi?
No, a bang beer.
A bang beer. A bang beer. I talk a Bambi.
Rudolph.
Bambi, it's a baby Bambi. Yeah, yeah.
Bobos.
Bobos. Hey, Bambi.
Central!
Central!
Central! Pimple! Pimple! Deal!
Pepin!
Huh?
Pepin!
Pepper? Pepper. What, play a Peppa Pig again?
Pepper. 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 Pepper.
Pedantry. Pedant.
Pedant. Holly.
Chestnut.
Chestnut. Pip.
Over fire.
Over fire.
Yeah.
Over fire.
Really?
Papa Crispin.
Papa Crispin.
Mulled wine. Oh, I love it.
What did I get?
Mulled wine.
Gildana.
Look.
Gildana. Hesitatum. Dingo. Big Mac Pudding. Peppa Pig voting. Big Mac Pudding. You're not so loud.
Oh, hurry up.
Give me pudding.
Elves!
Elves!
He's
Pig.
Out.
Oh, all right. Owen.
No.
Owen. Owen.
Hesitatum. Yeah, it's your fault, Owen. That was your fault.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Zapping.
Napping?
Zapping.
Zapping. Boom.
A snowball.
Snowball. Bimble. Rapping pepper keepers. Zapping. Wrapping paper thing.
Wrapping Christmas paper.
Wrapping pieces of paper.
Wrapping.
Wrapping.
Christmas. Paper.
Wrapping Christmas paper. Oh, you mean Christmas wrapping paper? It's talking like Yoda from Star Wars.
Wrapping Christmas paper it is.
Christmas wrapping paper.
Christmas star.
Christmas who?
A ribbon.
A ribbon?
Yeah, well, you wrap the wrapping paper with a ribbon.
Oh, ribbon. Yeah, ribbon.
A ribbon.
Yeah, ribbon. A ribbon that if you push and your dad gets your car for Christmas, she's got a ribbon on it. You go, I love you, Dad. Stop hurting me now when nobody's looking. That was bad. I'm sorry, baby Jesus. Happy birthday. Boom, boom.
Stocking.
Stocking. Jingle.
The boat that you put on the bedroom.
The what? The what? The juice that the boat that put on the bedroom.
Yeah.
It's that boat.
It's a boat?
It's a ribbon, yeah.
Oh, ribbon boat. A boat is made of ribbon. Yeah, sorry, sorry. Polly.
Okay. Shepherd.
Shepherd. Danny.
I'm done.
Yep, yep.
Nativity.
Nativity.
Stuffing.
Stuffing.
Oh, shit!
We've had stuffing! Oh. That means the winner is Fern's team! Oh. And the scores are the end of the Road Roll Short Trip! We're going to an ad break now, so enjoy all those toys where the parents are going to go, fuck me how much, you ain't getting one of them! See you after break! Coming up after break!
It's an old bug. What are you saying now?
Merry Christmas! Welcome back to Celebrity Joe's. Now, Piers, we've got to talk about the big thing that happened this year with one of your friends.
Yes.
Tell us about Donald Trump.
He's a good bloke. I like Donald Trump. I've known him nearly 10 years.
You've known him for 10 years?
Yeah, he's a good guy. He's a good business guy. He's pretty tough. He's ruthless. He's, as we can see, someone who's very competitive and quite outspoken. But he's now the most powerful man on God's earth, and he's my mate.
He's phoned you today, hasn't he?
He has phoned me today.
What, for advice?
I was actually asleep and missed a call. I woke up to a voicemail. It just said, "This is from the office of President-elect Donald Trump. Could you call him? He wants to have a word." I was like, you know what? I'll get back to him after Celebrity Jews.
America in safe hands, do you think?
I would just wait and see. Yeah. I think he'll surprise people.
Right. Danny, what do you think?
He's got a massive ego, but he's got a right small cock.
Are you talking about Trump or me?
That's my political view. I'm a political man, as you can see. You know. Just fucking clock myself, fucking.
Now, Danny Dyer, remember last time you were on and you presented your own kids show?
Good, we're not.
There you are.
That's my favourite thing ever.
A little bit Timmy Mallet-esque. All you had to do in the round was not swear, cos it was kids' telly.
Yeah.
And you didn't do very well, did you?
No, I thought I don't know why.
It was entertaining, but now and again you said fuck, bugger and shit. So as it's Christmas, we're going to give you another chance to get onto Santa's good list, on his nice list, yeah? So let's play!
Magical fun time with Uncle Daddy! Mappy!
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to Magical Fun Times with Uncle Danny. Can you guess what time of year it is? Yeah? It's Christmas, isn't it? Whoa!
Birdie, wordy. It's birdie wordy.
What's that, everybody? I think it's birdie wordy. Christmas, Bernie. Stop that. Stop it. Say hello to the boys and girls, Bernie Wordy. Say hello to the boys and girls. Well, come here. Come here. See you. Come here. Come here. What, what's that, Bernie Wordy? You brought your mate with you. Thank fuck for that, the phone's ringing. It's time to talk to the birds, to the boys and girls at home. Hello.
Hi, Danny.
Oh, hello, Graham.
Danny, I've got a question for you.
Go on, Graham, go for it, mate.
Danny, do you think now you've done EastEnders, you're not considered a proper actor anymore?
No, Graham, actually, Graham, I feel the opposite. I feel now that I've done EastEnders that I've now... You spiteful bastard. You put it right on the nipple there. No, it's right on the nipple there. No, I actually feel that being in EastEnders has actually proved that I can act because people thought I was a bit of a laughing stock. Not that I am now. All things going well. So, no, actually, I'm very proud to be part of that show. I'll tell you that now, and I love every second of it, Graham. OK, ta-ta of it. Ah, little lime foot, Bruno from Sheffield. Hello, Bruno.
Hi, Danny.
Hello.
I've heard you have a sweet little song you sing to Birdie Weirdy.
To calm him.
Sorry? Birdie Weirdy or Birdie Weirdy?
Sorry, Birdie Wardy.
Birdie Wardy.
Can you sing it now?
Of course I can. I've been dying to sing it. Birdie, wordie, you're fucking irritating. I'd love to put the nut on you. But as it's Christmas and your family are around me, I think I'll just go for the nice slow nosh. Line 5, Lily from Canterbury. Hello, Lily.
Hi, Danny.
Hello, darling. You all right?
Yeah, except that I accidentally put a pencil up my bum. How do I get it out?
How big's a pencil? Is it a big pencil or a little one?
It's your standard HB.
Right, how far up have you pushed it? Quick look, have a look. Can you see? Can you see the rubber? If you can see the rubber, cop to the rubber, and then slowly pull it out, darling. All right. Yeah. Okay. See you later, Lily. So we've got time for boys and girls. I hope you had as fun as me. And I will. I'll see you next time. I'm sure I'll see you all next week for some more magical Christmas fun times with Uncle Danny. Merry Christmas, ladies and gentlemen.
Magical fun. With Uncle Danny.
It's now time for the annual Lemon Awards! Seventh annual awards. That's exciting, isn't it, Piers?
Very exciting.
These are the awards voted by you, the general public. If you correctly guess who has won the awards, you'll win a point for the team. First up, Fern. Your category is most surprising celebrity breakup.
Right.
The nominees are Professor Green and Millie McIntosh, Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie, Taylor Swift and Tom Hiddleston, Stevie Ritchie and Chloe Jasmine. But who won the Lemon Award, Fern's team?
Brad and Ange.
You think it's Brad and Ange?
Big time.
Mm. Yep, that's the final answer?
Yeah.
Okay, I have the answer here.
Can I ask what's the point of having the envelope closed? I mean, you can just read from your...
Just for telling, Gina. It's a bit of fun. Bit of fun. It's Christmas. Bit of fun.
Ooh. Oh. Ooh.
The answer is... Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie! Now, here is the award. Unfortunately, Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie couldn't be here for legal reasons. They're going through a lot of trouble and turmoil. But they have genuinely sent us a VT via Skype earlier today and we've recorded it, so here it is. In Hollywood, I'm busy on my new film, Maleficent 2, which will be coming out on 4K, 3D, HD, all the formats that the kids are enjoying right now. I'd like to say thanks for this award. It's a shame that it's under such sad circumstances, but I'll be honest with you, it was all his fault. It's all his fault.
All those things you accuse me of, I didn't do!
I can't even tell what accent that's supposed to be, but he's a liar, I'll tell you that. He's a fucking liar and a lazy arsehole. You're a mess and a liar. Thanks for this award. It is mine. It's standing on a box, for fuck's sake. Look at that. You're a liar, Bradbury. I don't care how fit you are. Buy your feet. Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt there.
I'm up to go.
OK, this is another Christmas category. This is for you, Holly's team, so okay. Recognise. Your category is Celebrity Beef of the Year.
Celebrity Beef?
Yes. I tell you, the nominees are Taylor Swift and Kanye West after he claimed he made her famous. Gino DiCampo and Fred Syriex for fighting on Celebrity Juice. Kim Kardashian and some nasty burglars in Paris who stole $10 million worth of jewellery from her, bastards. And Danny Dyer and Matt Wright for having a dust-up at the festival. But only the British public said had the best beef this year.
Oh, I don't know.
One sec, what's happened there?
Nah, five of his pals tried to jump me, but they all look like status quo, so I just laughed. Like a shit status quo, you know.
Well, that's going to help your answer, I guess.
Was there beef between you and Fred Syriex? I mean, we saw it. Yeah. Was that for real? Was that, like, real kind of... Did you mean
it? Had a tear-up. Did you have a tear-up?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. I didn't know if it was real.
Yeah, but it's always a little bit of bristling between Italian and French. I wouldn't think people would pick up, you know. It's just...
Holly, to help you decide, he's actually sent you a VT.
Oh, Fred.
Yeah, look at this.
Merry Christmas, Gino. And please make sure you look after your tiny little pecorino during the festive period.
This is what I mean. I mean, what do you say?
Give him a Christmas message, you know.
A Christmas message?
Yeah, a lovely peace on earth, goodwill to all men, even Frenchmen.
I've got nothing against French people. But I got something against you, little motherfucking piece of shit, French bearded fucking coglione testa di cazzo, fuck you!
Quality!
And Merry Christmas!
Well, Holly, who are you going for then?
The Kim Kardashian thing wasn't really beef. That was just like, that was like a really horrible,
it was horrible.
Crime.
Yeah.
Taylor and Kanye, because like he recorded her voice and it all got a bit messy.
It's not like an ongoing beef with them.
Well, yeah. Everyone knows about that.
Yeah.
I'd say that one.
Taylor and Kanye?
Yeah.
Right, let's find out. Here it is. Beef of the year. The
Dermot O'Leary knows he's been booted out straight away, but he'll go, oh, I'll find out. He knows in his ear straight away. I can tell you that the beef of the year was... it's Danny Dyer and Mark Wright! Unfortunately, Danny Dyer can't be here tonight, but he has sent us a video message. Have a look at this.
What do you want me to say? What do you fucking want me to say? Thanks for these fucking awards. Thanks to my missus, she's a fucking salt. Thanks to Mark Wright. Well, I've got to say about Mark Wright, he's a sexy fucking bastard, isn't he? With all that fucking geezers, where's all this fucking ginger mop?
Thanks, Danny Dyer, for sending us that message. Oh, you're here. Thanks for recording that earlier for us. No, good sport. No. Always a good sport. You
and the scores at the end of that round are jingling.
We're going to go to an ad break now. We'll see you in three. Coming up after break.
Raccoon special. I'm outside Elm Street. I think it might snow, but who cares? We're here to play the box game, Christmas edition, still sponsored by Boxes. Let's talk to some of our contestants. As you can see, they're in special Christmas edition boxes. Danny, this has got to be the highlight of your career, yeah?
I farted in a box. So that's... there's no way to cog it, won't we?
Got Susanna at the back here. How are you feeling behind Piers?
I never realised how claustrophobic I was.
She's loving it, she's having time of life. Piers!
Yes?
How are you feeling? Are you feeling like a winner?
I'm feeling absolutely bloody ridiculous.
Yeah, like a winner!
Get out of here. What?
I just wanted to see you with your eyes.
I was a serious news anchor man.
You're definitely an anchor man. Okay, let me tell you what's going to happen. You're going to go down the Christmas slope into the Christmas presents. You will zigzag through the Christmas forest via the snowmen. They won't come alive. It's not that film where he comes alive and flies through the air with Ali Jones. You will also meet Carl the Elf on the bottom. Beware of him because he's very angry. He's been drinking and he's got his candy cane and he may swipe you with it. Avoid him. Go into the studio, then up the ramp. The first full team past the finishing line will win the game.
Get on with it, Lemon.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you steady?
Yeah.
Go! And they're off! Oh, it's a good start. Look at this. All the guys are going forward. They're through the Christmas presents. Through the Christmas presents. Danny Dyer's coming. Danny Dyer's out of his box. He's out of his box. I'm going to edit him there. Christmas ball, all of them have gone round, I hope that counts. Susanna's going the wrong way, I'm going to help her a little bit. There she goes. Oh, Gino and Danny are neck and neck.
Gino!
The neck and neck. Oh, Gino's bumped into a snowman. Go around the snowman. Can't get round the snowman. Holly's having trouble too. Holly, normally competitive. Danny Dyer, stop coming out of your box. Gino is going into the wall. From Santa. Annie, keep in your box. The girls are closely behind. I say close, I mean miles away. Pierce. Let me disguise you a little bit. You're going the wrong way. Danny Dyer is in the lane. Oh, it looks like Cotton is picking up. Cotton is approaching the studio. Closely followed by Susanna Rain. Holly.
This way.
Oh, could it be Susanna Reed next? Or is it going to be Danny Dyer? Is it going to be Susanna or Danny Dyer?
anyone who completed the race. Gino's still out there, I think.
Holly!
The winning team was none other than Ferncon's team!
Yes.
It's Christmas time, it's Christmas time. Mistletoe and wine, how are you feeling?
Yeah, really good.
How what are your hopes for the future?
Christmas joy to be spread around the world and for Gino to never come back.
Yeah, I'm just still in time whilst Gino De Campo comes back. I'll speak to Piers Morgan. Did you enjoy
Hello?
That?
Where the fuck is Gino? Not Hello? Even entered Hello? The studio.
It's a different postcode.
Is it Get in here!
Follow me.
I'm sweating.
You're not far. Keep going.
It's very hot in the Swansea.
You're right.
Are we there?
No. Well, nearly. Look, when you come in here, everybody's going to give you a really big cheer.
Should I say Antonio Banderas? you kept talking about Swansea out there. What was Swansea got?
The Swansea's hot.
Oh, the Swansea. I thought you said Swansea. You went the wrong way, but it's Christmas, so it don't matter. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. And the scores at the end of that round are shooting! We're going to an air break. We'll see you in three. One fire! Christmas special. Before the break, we played the Box Game Christmas Edition, still sponsored by Boxes. It was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Gino, do you remember last series when we got you to answer very important science questions as asked by Stephen Hawking, such as, can you eat your dinner if it's fired at you at the speed of light?
Yes, I hate it.
You loved it, didn't you? You loved it.
I hate it.
It's Christmas, you loved it, and because it's Christmas, let's have a visual recap of that. 3, 2, 1!
I'm not doing that.
Well, Antonio Banderas, because it's Christmas, because we're friends, I'm going to give you a chance to eat your Christmas dinner that way.
Yes!
Yes! Yes! And this time you won't be doing it by yourself, you'll be doing it with your teammate, Piers Morgan, as we play...
Can you catch your Christmas dinner whilst it's travelling at the speed of light?
Twas Christmas in the household of the brothers, Gino De Campo and Piers Morgan, and the boys were very excited to eat their Christmas dinner. Although this year, it was going to be a little bit different. They weren't going to be eating their dinner off plates at the table. They were going to be catching their dinner at the speed of light, fired by Susanna Reid and Fern Cotton. It's really exciting, isn't it?
Fuck off.
And this is supposed to be our household.
Your asshole? Hold.
Yes.
Yes. This is your house. Your brothers. So are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Put your visor down. Put your visor down.
Put our visor down.
You will start with the turkey and stuffing.
Right, happily.
Yeah. So are you ready? You've got turkey stuffing and cranberry sauce coming out. All you have to do is catch a little bit of it for a point for your team. Oh, Gino De Campo.
It comes from the gun and not from our nostrils.
No, just from the
to piss me off before I fire food at you, Italian dick.
Are you ready?
Yes.
3, 2, 1, fire! boob?
It hurts. It's hurt my boob.
Oh.
Yeah.
Do you want this to look a bit better?
I think I came off worse out of that than you did.
Next up, we're going to go with a bit of gravy. Gravy cutter.
Who doesn't love gravy?
Well, you need gravy with your turkey, don't you?
A little bit higher.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, yeah.
3, 2, 1, go! Oh, yes! Oh, yes, we're both doing well! Oh, look at that!
Oh, this is the most fun I've ever had with Piers Morgan.
Let's go for the next one. We're going for the veg, carrots, peas, the roast potatoes. You can't have a Christmas dinner without roast potatoes. Here's the veg.
Oh, my God.
Yes, that's it. Tuck your veg up. Are you ready?
Oh, no.
3, 2, 1, go.
OK.
Anything?
No,
nothing.
Nothing.
Hey, peace. A lot of people don't like them, but I do. Let's go with sprouts.
Let's go sprouts.
Okay. Sprouts.
Let's sprouts.
Get the sprouts.
Seriously.
3, 2, 1, go. Christmas time.
Let's have a refreshment break.
What the fuck is an eggnog?
I love it. I love it.
Christmas ain't Christmas without eggnog. 3, 2, 1, go! Merry Christmas! Tell you what, after your Christmas dinner, it's nice to have a mince pie, isn't it?
Oh, oh yeah.
Because you hurt your boobs, should we get Danny to fire it for
yeah.
you? Yeah, yeah. Danny, do you want to have a go?
I'd love to.
He'd love to have a go.
Careful.
See what you get.
Holly,
what,
so you would you like to have a go? Yeah. Let's have a go. Holly's going to have a go. Holly's going to have a go.
Yeah.
Well, hold up.
Go on, Dolly. Yeah, man.
Aim for the bowl. Help them. It's Christmas time. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself catching them. Remember, Christmas is not just about giving. It's also about receiving. So, Holly and Danny, let them receive. Go!
I got it.
You got it?
Right, let's see who got the most. Let's travel over. So, you've got in there, you've got the gravy. It's like a mixture of the gravy and the eggnog.
And the mince pies.
And the mince pies. You've done really well there. What have you got?
Sprouts.
Sprouts. Veg, there's some peas.
Veg, peas. I got the
eggnog and gravy.
The turkey.
Yeah, I have a bit of turkey, you know. Yeah.
So, they're telling me that you both have received 1 point for your team. Have you got anything to say to Susanna?
Revenge is a dish tasted cold.
Yeah, yes. And you just found out.
Well done to Gino and Piers! They loved it! They loved it!
How do you catch your Christmas dinner whilst it's travelling at the speed of light? Oh, oh, oh.
At the end of our Christmas special, I can tell you that the winning team was... Piers, I've got to be serious with you. You look like Grandad that's wet himself. You've enjoyed it, haven't you?
I've had a great time.
He's had a great
yeah,
time.
Can't wait to come
and
back.
It doesn't matter if you win or lose, does it?
Of course it matters if you win or lose.
Piers, I am really pleased you're having a good time because I can tell that your team hasn't won. It was Fans Day! Keith Lemon! If I don't see you for a week, I'll see you in 2007!